Sonya Hughes, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Sonya's a client of Sensible Fitness, an incredible story of success, and she's here to share it with you. At the same time she shares her story, we're going to do some exercises that you can incorporate into your program, and what we're going to tone up today is the triceps, the back of the arm.
One of my biggest problem areas.
I hear that from men and women. You know, they hate that loose, flabby stuff.
Can't stand it.
We're going to do a close grip bench press. We're going to use a barbell. Sonya, why don't you go ahead and lay down on the bench.
Okay.
And she's going to grab this close, about the width of her shoulders, maybe even a little bit narrower than her shoulders.
Right there.
And what she's going to do is bring the weight down to her chest, keeping her elbows at her side, and then press it back up. Why don't you do about 15 of those, as I explain. Hopefully she's breathing, because we want you to exhale as you push that weight up. With a close grip bench press, again, your hands are fairly close, a little bit narrower than your shoulders. When you bring the weight down towards the middle of your chest or towards your lower chest, you keep your elbows to your side. And you can see when she brings that weight down that she gets a tremendous amount of bending in the elbow. And that's what the tricep is going to do, is straighten the elbow. That is what the triceps do. They are elbow extenders, okay? So we are getting extension of the elbow as she pushes that up. And because your hands are close, it forces your elbow to bend more, so it takes emphasis off the chest, which typically a bench press is a chest exercise, with the triceps being a secondary muscle. When we change the grip, it gets a lot more triceps and less chest, so we can, with the same bench pressing exercise, change the muscle that's getting hit by moving your grip around. How you doing there?
I'm good, I'm done.
Are you? I'll take that.
Thank you.
Okay, go ahead and sit up. Now, Sonya was, I mean, at one time in your life, you were obese, right?
Yes, very much so.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Actually, twice in my life.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So you've done the yo-yo thing?
Yes, I've done the yo-yo dieting, which I'm sure a lot of people have. And, you know, I've, in the last couple of years, I've really started working out almost daily, and that has helped keep me on track.
Okay.
I mean, I cheat from, you know, from now and then, and I think you have to,
or you'll go crazy.
Taking clients to lunch, cocktail hours with clients after work,
right.
It definitely adds up. So.
And she does that daily.
Daily.
I mean, it's every day.
Yes.
I mean, I've tried to take her out for a drink. I'm busy. She's always out entertaining.
Yes.
And so it's hard at restaurants to eat healthy.
It's almost impossible. It really is. Restaurants don't make it easy. I mean, that's part of the problem with this country. I mean, we consume too much fast food. And, you know, even if you're sitting down to a really nice dinner at a restaurant, you're still consuming a lot more fat. You're not in control.
Right.
So I've really tried to portion things. I'll have them package half my dinner and bring it to me at the end of the meal.
Okay.
I mean, I just try to make smarter choices. I do cheat from here, you know, from now and then, but, you know, it's just a common, just a daily struggle that I think we all, you know, entertain in our lives.
And what I like, and I hope you're picking up on this, is that Sonya has these obstacles, the entertaining of clients, eating at restaurants, happy hour type things, social events. She doesn't use that as an excuse. Oh, well, you know, I have to do this and be 200 pounds. Instead,
right.
It's an obstacle, but she overcomes it. She just said, you know, she packs half of her meal and brings it home the next day. She makes wiser choices. You exercise all the time.
All the time.
So
I probably average around 50 miles a week.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And just years ago, she was in a car wreck in a wheelchair and a walker. Was your pelvis that was crushed?
My pelvis was crushed, half of your body. Yeah, my arm was broken, my leg, my meniscus was completely severed. My pelvis was in pieces, and that was the longest process, the healing process, was getting through that.
Right.
And, I mean, they didn't know how well I would fare from all the surgeries, but I've been extremely lucky.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She just recently completed a marathon.
Yep.
I mean, you're amazing.
Thanks.
It's awesome. I love it. Why don't you lay down? We're going to do a second set. Okay. Sonya's doing about 15 repetitions, and we base our repetitions on what your fitness goals is. If you're someone who's trying to get as strong as you can, there's a certain number of repetitions that you perform. If you want to get bigger, like guys who want to bodybuild, there's a certain number of repetitions. Sonya has a goal of muscle tone with endurance, just general fitness goals, and so we're giving her about 15 repetitions. And normally we give her a weight that's very challenging to get to on her 15th rep, but we're keeping it a little bit light here so that she can breathe and talk and tell us her story. And so I don't have to jump up and pick the bar up off her chest if it crushes her. So, but Sonya's a very hard worker. It's been amazing to see her transformation. She's lost a lot of weight and she's keeping it off. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I cheated last night. You're talking about cheating. I cheated last night. We all do that. And that's just, you're getting close?
I'm done.
That's just something that we have to deal with. But you don't screw up and then say, oh well, and get up the next day and eat biscuits and gravy and ice cream. I mean, you get up and you say, I screwed up. You stick to your program. Mm-hmm. And it's just a speed bump.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, since I've started this whole process, I've gone from a size 14 almost to 16, which is embarrassing to admit at my age and my size, to about a 6'8". And that's pretty cool. Much where I'm staying. So
that's awesome.
As long as I stay there and I continue to work out and continue to build strength, I'm happy.
Okay.
I'm really happy.
And so you're living a much higher quality of life.
Absolutely.
And that's, I mean, there's so many people out there, they accept the fact, oh, my knee is sore, oh, this or that, and they let it limit their life. And her whole body was crushed in a car wreck, and she refuses to, let that stop her.
Yeah. No way. I mean, I'm in my mid-40s, and as I get older, it's only going to get worse, because I have recently been diagnosed with severe arthritis in my neck as a result of the accident. So the fact that I've worked really hard and I continue to go down this path, I know it's only going to help me as I get older with this, dealing with this. So
you're so smart. Well, you are. I mean, because there's people out there in their 40s or 50s, mm-hmm. and they're not doing anything. And they're blind to what the future holds to them.
Right.
And the quality of life that you're going to be living in 20 years. Are you going to be in a nursing home, in a rocking chair, in a wheelchair? Are you going to be dependent? Or are you going to be independent and strong and doing things to make your future brighter? Because right now in your 40s and 50s, this is a very important part of your life.
Absolutely. And I almost consider the accident sort of a blessing in disguise, because had I not gone through all of those issues and just with the rehabilitation, would I really take my health as seriously as I do now?
Okay.
And I don't know if I could answer that question honestly.
That was a little bit of a wake-up call for you?
Yes, most definitely.
Okay.
Yeah, just lifestyle choices. I mean, it was definitely starting to take a toll at that point. So, I've put on the brakes on a lot of things, especially recently.
You're awesome.
Oh, thanks.
You are. Thanks for being on the show.
My pleasure.
Shake my hand. Thanks, Sonya.
My pleasure.